And welcome to Die Dragon Die Presents Legends Campaign Episode 25. I'm the DM here in this shenaniganry. Marty, I'm joined by my friends and cohorts, Adam, John, Ahmed, and Mark. We are in Sudbury, broadcasting from on the road at Mark's pad. Way cool to roll dice with most of the players in the same location at the same time. Speaking of dice, where did my dice bag go? I'll have to go and get that in a second.
Got the cheater die over here.
Got the cheater die over there, which is a gigantic d20. I'm just going to take a quick look to see how the stream looks. Crazy. Okay.
Looks good.
All of our faces are there. Just tilt that down. All right. So we had a marathon session yesterday, which was episode 24, which we called what? What was the name of the episode? Men Amongst Dwarves was the name of the episode. Where? How do we do a recap? I think like the players do a recap. What the heck happened last game? Sometimes it's fun to hear them tell the story.
Do you want the long version, short version, or the really short version?
I want to hear the really short version first.
We won!
You won D&D. Okay, great.
The long version?
Let's unmute John, if I'm being rude here. How's it going, John?
What? Oh, was I muted? Okay.
He wasn't ready. It happens.
Otherwise, I just start fucking talking to myself. I can't see your screen on your camera. I just see the VC. I don't see anything else.
Yeah, because XSplit is a hog and it's got the camera. So, same problem.
Well, it worked last time, but whatever.
No, it worked after the evening. After we stopped XSplit, it worked.
No, it was working the entire game. I was able to see everything. But, anyways. Nothing happened since last game. I was asleep, and now I'm awake.
Awesome.
You slept?
Yep. Let's play more D&D.
So, last session, we were sent a grim box containing... Oh, sorry, there was an apparition that came during the evening.
Yes.
When the party rested outside Dvergholme.
And the paladin just kind of went...
The paladin went...
Not noteworthy.
We're not going to tell anybody about this ghost that visited me.
Irrelevant ramblings of a madman.
Morning comes, and a very grim package is delivered by the Dwarvish ambassador. In the package, there is a hand, as well as a curse and a note, basically saying, "Fuck you, adventurers, come at it me, brah." Uka woke up on a sandy beach with a mud legs, the dog something, muddy dog leg, the somebody who's like, "Give me money," and Uka's like, "No." "But you give me money now." "No." And then Uka challenged him to an arm wrestling contest, won the arm wrestling contest, and got a lock of his hair, which Uka is now thinking he's going to start collecting people's bits for polymorph spells, and then swam back ashore. The party then used the boat and a fly spell to ascend the waterfall. That's sort of the back way into Dvergholme, into the tunnels. And began the assault on the castle. Lemmy, using his wild shape, elemental body, successfully found some of the hostages and used a sending spell to confirm plans with some of the other allies within Dvergholme to perform a coordinated strike on the leadership. Lemmy rescued the Dwarvish women, while the rest of the party fought the things that were scary. It was Lemmy's harem, effectively. We sort of smashed our way into the throne room, and we fought... There was the Abjurer, who was controlling two giant golems with battle axe arms. There was the
Beetle
with the dispelling crossbow of screw you, guy with the dispelling crossbow.
Yes.
There was Lodrim, man of many tricks.
Yes.
There was a couple of slag giants who decided that they didn't want to fight anymore after they got defeated, so they didn't choose early enough. as well as several other goons and thugs and ne'er-do-wells. Nobody died. Lodron was really hard to defeat. He beat his ass repeatedly.
There's nobody died.
I thought there was a good chance he was going to get away.
There was a good chance he was going to get away. it was a really good coordinated effort. Like, every party member that was there and not just playing with women. The women.
Come on. Basically, there was a hallway of they just yell down the hallway and they start slaughtering their
Yes, exactly. No, he was there stopping us from, like, you know, having to explain why all the noble wives died.
And children.
And children. Yeah, no, it was very good. Then Lokrik decided... Oh, then we paraded Lodrum through town.
And the head of the Vilgrin Troll.
And the head of the Vilgrin Troll was shown. And we sort of threw him in a magical prison. Brook. In you go, because we don't really want to solve this. Do we kill him? What do we do? Question, and then we started the downtime. Lokrik became declared king.
Heir.
Heir to the king. He'll become king when he turns 50. Galeth made an epic speech of, "You suck, dwarves. We're humans. We're better than you." I was more of a dwarf than you were on the day of dwarving.
Actually, yeah, that's right.
How much dwarf could a dwarf?
We should just forever known as that.
I think that's performed poor limerick or something.
And then there was some clearing of the road, and Lenny got his brain stuck in a couple of weird anti-magic suction cones. Things?
Oh,
yeah.
I don't know what it was.
Yeah, so we're sort of in the middle of downtime where we're kind of flipping through days as people are crafting, but there are some things that players have decided, because they've got spells and powers, they want to sort of investigate or get answers. So that's also a valid thing to happen during downtime as well.
I picked up a giant stone! That makes Uka happy.
So one of the ways we track this is kind of like, you know, project management 101. What are the things that you guys are all doing in the different tracks that are your PCs? Green equals done. So Oberon has actually started crafting. That's when he got interrupted by the weird sendings and scryings. Did you have the proper one? So you sent to High Sapper, Gemadry, your grandfather, grandmother. It was your mother and father. It was your father where things started getting weird, right?
Sending to father, it was weird. Scrying on mother was second.
Okay, can you change the sending on mother to scrying on mother?
Oh, okay, yeah. And the
Lokrik just gets caught up in rulership duties, so I'm just going to say that he's busy doing that for the next little while. We don't need to roleplay any of the crafting that Lokrik is doing, so I'm going to go all the way down to when he's done his own items. Scrying on Mother was done.
Yes.
Okay, act as guide. Yes, yeah, so you guys have returned with the animals.
And as he's almost in there,
And then the paladin was basically...
He's not even close.
Helping Lokrik for a few days. Yeah, acting as guide is done.
You loved me, just smacked me and said I was doing it wrong.
Helping with Lokrik is done.
How come this doesn't work in other relationships?
Okay. So it looks like, where did we leave off? I think Ahmed was the one we left off with, so we'll go to doing that. Okay. Let's see. Clear the roads I've got for Isildin.
Yeah.
So you're just patrolling the old dwarf road?
Yeah.
Okay, give me a level check. And are you just waltzing up and down the road like you did before? Or are you sneaking along to see what you can find?
But he's by himself.
Okay.
18.
18 total?
Yeah.
Okay. Since the last time you walked out on the old Dwerg Road to go get the animals, there were much more Esclav that were there. They seemed to be slowly dispersing. Mm-hmm. And then perhaps you and Uker kind of beating them up along the road convinced them that the road was no longer a safe spot.
We weren't beating them up. We were diplomacying them.
let me just see if I have a picture to share with you of the... And let me quit being lazy, and I'll switch to the world map to show what Azulvan is doing. Fosgard. There's the world map. There's Dvergholme. There's where you picked up. Picked up the animals, I believe, was... Yeah. I created dots before. They disappeared. Oh, I guess that campsite isn't no longer needed. The old stone road. Yeah, the Heroes of Aegis are actually at Dvergholme. And Azildan's basically going down this road. And how far down the road are you going? Are you going all the way to the end to see what you see? Because before, when you guys approached the road, you actually kind of approached just to the north and then went up. So you actually don't know what this dog
is. He'll go to...
Fijel Kris?
Yes.
Okay.
Fijel Kris.
All right. Let me see if I have a map for Fijel Kris. I think I just got a picture. Might be a file that didn't make it to potential tokens and maps.
And maybe I turned around before you.
Maybe there's a big black wall with yellow letters in the corner saying, I don't know how this. Error 404.
Maybe like in so many games, this is that part where you start running and you just don't go anywhere. You just slide along this
one slide along area. This one visible wall. Perhaps there was a road that had a rock fall down in front of it and there's no way around.
No way. No.
Certainly couldn't go through the trees. That's nonsense. some type of ranger would think I'd be going through the trees. Woodsman? Yes, we do.
Not here, you're not.
Not here, you're not. Is this no resolution? Push JPEG on the wall.
Let me just see if I can refine it, because... There was an awesome cast. Okay. Me searching for images.
What could we do to make this more exciting? We should say something.
I'm going to make Tanglefoot bags to be a dick.
Okay, we'll use this one. I will create a map for it.
Bag of glue. Do you want to create a map or just throw a pick out?
Yeah, I'll create a map.
Griff just uses it when he needs to know what's just like.
Catch, bitch.
This took me 2 days, 25 gold to make. Totally worth it. Worth it. Next one. This is a custom one that died. Forever shall be Papa. Noble Yabo.
Joel's being freaky again.
Ooh.
So the large stone bridge, the stone road turns into a stone bridge that crosses a narrow point in the river that the dwarves have built. Yet another impressive fortification. This one's made out of stone. It's not as big as Dvergholme, but Isildin would guess that, well, I don't know, 500 halflings could be inside that building.
So it gauges everything. There's about 4 halflings.
There doesn't seem to be a lot of activity, but you do see some banners that are floating. They're the same kind of cut of banners that are at Dvergholme.
Alright.
Isildin does notice that there are quite a few ravens that are roosting on this castle.
Isildin goes into stealth mode.
Okay.
He will cast... He's going to cast air... Well, he'll just go fly and... Instead of just going up to the doors, it'll kind of go and fly around windows. What's going on?
All right, give me a stealth check.
All right. That's my new stealth. I can't remember anymore. Two higher than one before? One higher than one before. Three higher than one before. Oh, somebody's getting freaky.
3-6.
Good thing I'm getting a knife.
The Jill Crease is the name of this thing. 36.
Oh, with the ship we've been fighting?
Yeah.
Oh, I've got a 30 something. Oh, it only sees you all the time.
Well, it didn't blink, so it saw you.
Map tool is being really silly, so I'm going to just restart it. I say it.
Okay.
People on the stream can see it. Doing this thing where it's not refreshing.
Belly.
Yep.
Is this thumbs?
Yeah, it's fixed. I think I lost the picture though.
So we went to this giant building.
And it disappeared!
Good. You feed the building. Good job.
A mystery. Let us spend the rest of our lives investigating this.
What?
Okay. So you saw what the castle looks like. I'll just show a picture to those on the Twitch stream. You fly up into a few windows. There's this really large window that was in the center of the edifice that overlooks the bridge. You peek into there, and it does look like a large hall, like an open hall. You can see the many levels to the inside of the castle are open in this hall. This is where, if you wanted to have a battle, you'd probably want to have a battle in here to fly around. But there are many, many walkways that would be open down kind of in a gallery sort of view. You start flying around and peeking into other windows. There are dwarves here. The dwarves seem to be on guard. There are some dwarves that are armored in a similar way to the guards that were guarding Laudrum. This dark full plate armor, you see two of them marching down a hallway.
That's enough for me to ascertain their guilt.
Errors everywhere! No. Are there any who aren't?
Yep, they're dwarven soldiers.
Okay, he will perhaps.
So the main window is a big window, but there are the arrow slits. You could probably wiggle into one of the arrow slits.
Yeah, okay, we'll do that.
Okay, give me an escape artist.
Oh, he's getting stuck. He's so getting stuck. 19. Okay, oh, sorry, 20.
The DC was 15. Okay, so you...
You have to come and chop bits off.
Now you're inside the castle. You're inside a room where there's a... There are a couple of crossbows hanging on the wall and some quivers and that sort of thing and a bench, but it's really Spartan.
Okay. He's going to sneak around.
Okay, give me another stealth check as you're sneaking around inside the castle.
21.
What specifically are you looking for?
He's looking for, like, the sergeants from the throne room.
Okay.
He's looking for one of those guys.
Alright, can you roll a d6 to see how severe the you being spotted with a 21 is?
You can roll.
6 is an enemy, 1 is a relatively benign. 6?
Just gotta mention door barriers.
Yes, I do.
Okay. So you're sneaking along and you're like, hey, a good intersection, so I'm gonna look this way and then you look around. And then these dwarves are just kind of standing in a semicircle. There is a male. He looks like he's Esklav. And he's got, like, black feathers kind of stuck throughout his clothing. He turns around and the dwarves are like, hey!
Should pull a Han Solo here.
So, wait, this is a dwarf with feathers?
No. There are four armored dwarves that are similarly armed to Lodric's, or Lodrum's guards. Yeah. They have their helmets open. They were talking to an Esklav man, a fifth guy, that has raven feathers kind of in his getup. He's wearing leather armors. He's got a crooked-looking staff with a bird skull at the end of it.
Who are you? Halt!
Was one of the dwarves in Dwarven.
Hey, I come from Dvergo, alright? Knock it off with the halt.
Give me a diplomacy check.
These always go well for me. 3.
Alright, so you've got 3 guards with Dwarven war axes.
Okay.
And this man who's retreating from the row of dwarven axes, but he seems to be shrinking as he's retreating.
Aye, shrinky dink. Get back here.
Okay, roll initiative.
Raven Queen Baldwin. 10. Well, total.
10 total?
Yeah.
Okay.
With your initiative bond?
Yeah, it's been my arrow before.
4. All right, so the druid turns into a small raven and then begins to fly down the corridor.
Yeah, I'm going to miss you.
And then the four, then it's your turn because the four guys have got their axes out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't have spellcraft. Dumbo? If I cast old person on a polymorphed...
Oh.
I don't know.
No. I'm just making a suggestion that you cast a different spell on the raven if it's still visible. It was arrow. Lots of arrow. or fuck off. It's all you.
You know what we're going to do? We're going to spend a mythic point for a standard action.
Yep.
Which I will use to pull my bow.
Okay.
And I'll spend a key point to shoot me a raven.
You're going to spend a mythic point to shoot more raven?
To shoot more raven.
Yeah, there we go. You unleash an arrow storm down the hallway at the hapless bird.
And then he said, halt!
Mark's rolling a gigantic die right now. It's pretty funny.
AC 26, would that have hit?
Yes.
Okay, good. Then it's not a critical miss.
You pull out your bow and fire an arrow that ricochets off a torch.
You're lucky!
Milligy!
Yeah, that's right.
All right, so
27. 20.
Yep.
Yeah, that's with the key point there. No. I'm assuming 12 isn't hit.
12 is not.
And 23, so 3 hits.
Okay. Mark's using physical dice.
Yes.
There's a strange analog feeling. I gotta go find my dice too while you're doing this. I feel naked.
Oh, here. What's this? This is so.
I just double check.
How much damage do I do again? Because you've got another, you have more deadly aim than you used to.
Oh, well, that's because we're all buffed up. Yeah, I was just added like a plus 9 to hit and a plus 5 AC and plus 6 to damage with all everything up, yes. Like Bard Song, oh, yes. And Good Hope. Oh, yes.
Okay, my low-level druid has 28 hit points.
Mm-mm. Okay, he's done.
How much damage?
Oh, yeah, I just did 18 just with the dice.
And then the mods.
And then the mods, so many mods, it just falls.
Is he dead or is he unconscious?
No, he's dead. Unless he's got a huge con, he's dead.
Okay, so the... this strangely adorned, feather-adorned man kind of shoots out of this bird form and unceremoniously tumbles over with arrow snapping, and you heard a bone or two snapping as he's tumbling down the hallway. The dwarves charge in. They're going to take you alive or dead.
Gotcha, bitch!
Bitch doorway. I think I remember what these things are called. It's just a weird set of stats. Yeah. Alright, we'll dwarvatize these guys.
They're twites.
Okay, they're charging in. 3 times 1d20 plus 12 plus 2 for the charge. Oh, there are 4 of them. Oh, I guess only 3 of them
can be. Once you can charge, one of them has to move an attack for.
AC 17, AC 25, AC 27.
Yeah, I'll miss.
Okay, so you're dodging these axes. And the fourth one is running back down the hallway towards where the guy is. And he's about 60 feet away now down the hallway. He looks like he's about to turn a corner.
Oh, exactly.
The dwarf is like running away while the three of them are attacking with axes.
Okay.
Your turn. Because it's the druid's turn, and then it's your turn.
When the druid falls...
No, he fell and then turned big. Like, yeah. He's done. The rattle
punches,
is a special sound.
He put. Oh, no, he kicks one of the dwarves. 21.
These dwarves have AC 22.
I miss. And, oh, this could be a critical miss.
Why were you punching?
Because I didn't want to kill anybody.
I mean, dwarves.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Raven druids.
Raven druids are not people. Okay.
They're not people. Why'd you side with evil? Use it in a person.
It's a critical miss?
No, it is not a critical miss.
Okay.
Or wait. That's 9. Yes, that's a critical miss.
21. Set the percentile.
Actual dice. 90! That's gonna be good.
Dimension doorway!
That's how it's gonna end.
After they beat your ass for a bit. Hopefully you don't get stunned or something.
Yeah, we know how that goes.
Yo.
An AC of 50? Yeah, they're gonna hit you.
Okay. Now let me just find my critical miss and hit charge. 90?
90.
That's not good, Mark.
Please don't stun one. You could break your bow, you could break your fist, you could break off an arm, just don't get stunned.
Were you stunning fisting someone?
No.
Okay, alright.
Because I don't have that.
You do it's unarmed damage to yourself, but lethal.
Okay.
You can do that all day. You can just sit there and punch yourself with a dick repeatedly. Just don't
hold it.
He, th- throws a kick and hits armor and goes, and just goes, oh, it's been so long since I've actually kicked something.
So you're battling these dwarves with you're battling with these dwarves with the axes, and the dwarf that went running down the hallway went, Ekka! Intruders! It's at this point that we're going to make an opposed level check.
Okay.
Hold on, I need to figure out. So Ekka is being summoned. I'm going to give you a +2 to your roll because you're in combat mode and she wasn't. But basically, because we're in downtime rules, this is it's something.
Speed things up.
Yeah. So let me look at Hekka's level.
I'm pretty certain it'll be like a.
Sorry, I was a little unconscious.
Are we still fighting?
He found the Queen of Ravens.
Ekka, the Witch of Ravens, whose patron is Gull's Cap, who's behind a lot of what's been going on. She's
Ahmed?
At 12th level.
That Wonder Woman mug is big pimpin'. I think it's awesome.
So she rolls a 2, gets a 14. First, are you trying to escape or are you trying to win the day? I'll roll again if I assumed escape because I heard you guys talking about Dimension Dooring away. Is Zildan pushing it, or is he...
Zildan's can't dimension.
Can I spend a mythic point?
Yes.
He can't dimension.
And a hero point?
Yes, I'm going to roll again, though, because you're pushing it. But yes, you can spend a mythic point and a hero point.
All right. Okay, then I'm going to push it.
So that's a +16 plus 1d6.
Yes.
Because it went one, like 8 plus 8.
Yes.
Okay, so... Roll this where I can see.
This one's so small.
So mythic gives me another 4.
Okay.
So we're at 20. 28.
I can beat you.
You can beat me.
20 plus 12.
Oh god.
She rolls another 2.
Oh, I'm sorry. I should be done here. I'm awake now.
So Zildan ends up backing away from these guards, flying out a window. They switch up their weapons to crossbows. He flies out of the castle and finds another window to fly through. Like just jams through that window. You end up being in the Witch of Raven's face. And it's just the two of you. She looks like she's like got stuck growing out of a raven form. Like there's a female body and it's all covered in feathers, except there's a female face coming out of the feathers. Like there would be no mistaking her.
Hello.
She knows what righteous vengeance was visited upon the leaders of Esklav, and the fact that Perun of Diamond Skies had died, that she tries to escape. God, I'll do this automatically.
How?
I'm going to give you 2 full round attacks on her with your range. What is your range before you suffer range penalties?
Oh, it's 1,050 feet.
Okay. So what she did was she her hand went out, a broom went whoosh, right into her hand. Mm-hmm. She jumped on it and not without a cackle tried to fucking fly away. She's flying at 60 feet. She has to maneuver outside of the castle and then out... kind of trying to fly away from Azildan. So your first full round is her kind of in the hallway. Mm-hmm. Your next full round is finding an arrow slit and while she's trying to fly away.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
my bonus is to hit are not so great right now.
Is it four? It's 4 now. There's one.
Well, I'll be spending mythic and...
Mythic and key and then rapid shot and base. So that's 4.
Yeah.
4, number side.
No, it's... I get 4 base now. Yeah, I get 4 base now.
6. So, range sunder.
But the first 4 are, plus the
plus its base attack.
Range thunder? Just shoot the
four.
Shoot
the four.
Range thunder?
At plus 13, unfortunately.
Okay, so the first four attacks. AC 16 is not great. AC 30 is good. AC 23 is not great. AC 31 is pretty good.
So the last, so three hits.
All right, and the last two are at.
So it's 1d20 plus 8.
Plus.
And then a 1d20 or 2 at 1d20 plus 8 for the
yeah, that's right. I must say, I had time to cast the spell. But probably
so 21, 26. So,
sorry?
21, 26?
Yeah, that's yes, four or five. She didn't have any time to put up her defenses, so five hits.
So,
four hits, yeah.
Gravel.
Or,
1d8 plus 12.
5d8 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12 plus 12.
Just to be 12. Off standing up. And my new bow.
So it's 67 damage. Oh, look at that, those d8s. Those d8s suck.
Oh, they blew.
Right. From the first full round attack.
Yep. And now she thinks she's getting away.
Four numbers.
No, she's not laughing.
Yeah.
Over here, man.
So 25, 23, 20.
Is three.
So that's three. And then it's 20, 20 plus 8. That's a miss. Two number sign. 20 plus 8.
Perfect strike.
Misses.
Perfect strike.
That's the two.
18, you 18. Might as well add mythic points to some of those misses.
No, but you'd roll twice for the last one.
Yeah, that's yeah, it is so here. That was the extra air attack. And it's not sure.
Throw mythic points to try to
no, you
get
the plus 13.
Plus 13 for them.
Yeah. Plus 8.
One at plus 8.
Yeah.
And then two at.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see. Okay. So
okay, so it's three more hits.
Yeah, so another
3d8 plus 36.
Question, does a mythic...
48 damage.
48 plus 60.
So it's 115.
Okay, she's got 5 hit points left.
I will take attacks at a minus 4.
When she decides that she'll use...
Dimmer.
Invisibility?
What's her initiative?
Spend a mythic point for an extra standard action!
Did you spend a mythic point in any of those for standard actions?
It's a free action to use the standard action.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Did you use
your
mythic points in those? Okay.
Yeah. He used the mythic one for sudden strike. He didn't use the mythic extra action.
Got it.
Yeah.
So yes.
So you should do that.
She can surge. That hits. That turns the miss into a hit.
All right. So d8 plus 12.
15.
Okay. So she's just turning invisible as the last arrow comes in, hits her in the back, and now there's this tumbling woman on a errant.
So hard to shoot the ground.
Max 20d6 probably. Well, actually, no, her broom's flying, but she falls off of it. So, yeah, 20d6.
Just in case I was trying to, like, you know, contingency spells or whatever.
Oh, that's
see that minus flat.
Just in case somebody's 70. Trying to, you know, like, speak with dead with her afterwards. Yeah.
She's at minus 70.
Let's see. One is she went across, like she hit land across. Two is she hit the water. Three, she hit the castle on this side.
One.
So she actually got across the river and she tumbled into the wilderness somewhere.
He's going to try and fly and find her.
Okay.
You fly. Yeah, I've got a fly spell on. Oh.
A non-mythic character of your level could never have pulled that off.
No, probably
right.
Not.
And then I'm going to say Azildan clearing the roads is probably hunting down the people that shouldn't be that in the castle, kind of getting rid of them.
Leaving is staying. Leaving is staying. Rent's up.
Yeah, this castle's supposed to be underneath the control of our king.
You're not wearing the right armor.
Consider this your eviction notice, twang. Man, I wish someone was here to hear
this. Tenant board.
I think I like the downtime rules combat. Yes. Okay, so yeah, you do go find the Witch of Ravens. It's all kind of broken amongst a bunch of trees and splayed out.
Detect magic.
Yes, I know. He knows enough to do that.
Okay, there's enough things here that you would keep Oberon busy for a day or so. Are you taking the broom?
Yes, he's taking the broom.
Okay.
And he's the broom. Freaking try and use it, too.
So what you need to do is...
Because that looks like fun.
Gallop.
I would probably rule like the flying on the broom is probably the same as firing from mounted horseback. Yeah. So they're while it's fun, it's not
ideal.
And Gallith used this as a
weapon. So what you need to do is get your acrobatics. Stand on the broom, surf around.
No.
Okay. No, what it ends up being is Gallop.
He's just kind of using it like a skateboard at a certain point. Yeah, you're going to have to go bring it to Oberon.
Come on.
The broom.
He hands over on the broom. He finds it in the corner. He's just like sweeping with it.
That's an item, you ass.
So you've gathered up some stuff. When you go see Oberon next, you've got everything kind of hanging off the broom. And
but you know what? He makes no... Yeah, I found this stuff. You mind identifying it for me?
We'll get there in a moment. It's in the days that followed where you hunted down some Esclav. Yeah. You had some words with some soldiers that you thought maybe not on the right side, and there are people leaving the keep. At some point, you actually get some dwarves that wave you over and say, "Can you help us break into the jail to get our commander out?"
Oh, yeah!
So there's this scene where a bunch of dwarves and Isildin attacking some Esclav warriors and... some druids that were basically holding some of the important dwarves hostage. Given that you rolled a hero point to do this, the whole place is taken pretty much without any loss of the lives of those that are on the
good
side. Yeah. Sure.
Yeah.
And Isildin basically single-handedly slew the Witch of Ravens and then retook this place. That wasn't sending the proper amount of support to Dvergholme during the siege, and you can understand why. There were some people that were charmed. In fact, some of the soldiers, they asked for you not to kill, and they knocked them out, and you've got a group of about 20 dwarves that are all in quarantine because their heads aren't right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. But that's his coronation gift to Lurk.
I got you a castle.
Beat that!
So Isildin's down. Like he's making he went down a couple trips to go see where the witch's body, because she fell and you want to make sure that you collected everything. What did you do with her body? Or what remains of it?
He would have gross as it is. He finds it, collected the head.
Yeah.
Because he knows Lemmy can use that. Well, he could too, but he trusts Lemmy more with that sort of thing.
Sure.
Then he would have cremated the body.
Okay. We'll say it's a few days later after you took care of some things. You're actually having the pyre. You get the head nearby. And you caught out of the corner of your eye this golden flash from the river. Okay. It was kind of like a little bit of a, like a, was it a fish? You look and it was gone. So you go into stealth mode, give me a stealth check.
33.
Yeah, it went over there somewhere. Like you're heading now down to the edge of the river.
Survival tracker.
You'd have to go into the water, and then it's a wide rushing river.
Yeah.
The dwarves built the stone bridge at a spot where it would be very difficult to cross. Like, oh, it's just going a boat underneath. No, the thing is raging through the stones that it was built on.
Yell out in Vaslandic,
If you're there, come on out. I promise they won't hurt you, as long as you mean no harm.
We will say.
Damn it! Enchantment?
Yep.
Okay, so.
This is right here. 13?
13 to 15. 21.
Search.
Later about the
results.
You had these flashes of images of halfling women from Agrova that you've had a crush on, or flirting with the bar wench in Dvergholme, or you're kind of traveling on the road with Janica. Like, all those types of memories, you just kind of, they all flooded to your head at once. And then you heard this purr in your mind. I see. The multiple times you said, no time for love, you know, kind of like too busy sort of thing.
Yeah, what, why, who, what, that? You killed my friend. Show yourself. Why would you kill my friend? She was getting herself in all sorts of trouble when he's looking around.
Okay. You thought you saw the gold flash in the water again? It moved impossibly quick against the flow of the river.
Okay, he's trying to keep track or trying to find it.
Okay, you're now at the river's edge. If you go any further towards the river's edge, you'll leave the cover of trees that you're hiding behind. There are a couple of rocks you can continue to stealth towards, but...
All right, he's going to...
Cast dolphins?
Gonna cast Owl's Wisdom on himself.
Yep.
And try and sneak around.
Yeah, you're still sneaking.
But aren't you Ugar's friend?
I'm going to find out for sandy beaches.
Okay. Do you know Luca?
Yes. He's my lover.
I find that hard to believe. I'm pretty sure he would have mentioned you.
And if Luca's my lover, and you're his friend, why are you killing my friends?
First of all, being mentioned in a very fancy, you might just be kind of up. And the fact you ain't showing yourself, I'm guessing he ain't too proud of what he's done.
To be fair, Hooker has mentioned it.
And did Azildan see the woman in the water that took her away?
Yeah.
He kissed and did not want to tell.
Okay. There's a splash from the water, and there are a bunch of sparkling you know what they are the second you see them. There are a bunch of arrowheads. At least a half dozen of them.
Mm-hmm.
They get thrown out of the water, and they all kind of tink along the stones in front of you. They're yours.
Ah, thanks. I was looking for these.
Do you know where I found them?
I'm guessing Luca's ass.
In my son.
Oh. Well, to be perfectly honest, I think the one you want to talk to is Gallop. Got him.
And it was
you
at the day, let me tell you.
John. Never seen a wolf cry so loud.
Cried a little bit. Oh, I felt bad for the lad. I did.
Then I shot you there.
Just for... He got an 18 on his bluff. Just so quick.
It was nice knowing you, Azildan.
You can have your field of victory. Azildan Lakelander.
Why are you calling me that?
He will join you soon. He was right by Griffiths. And the likes of you and your people will not survive Ragnarok.
Who or what is a Ragnarok? Oh, wait, that sounds true. Is that coming soon? Because we now have the mind.
She did mention that she was kind of a nihilist.
Please pass along to your friends that we'll be seeing each other soon.
I'm sure we're going to follow to that.
This is your fault.
It's not my fault.
She seems reluctant to show herself, like you thought you were in trouble.
Yeah.
That's a scandal.
Okay. There's a gold flash. And then you notice the river just kind of runs dry.
What? Control water. That wheel.
Or thirsty.
And you see fish flopping around.
Sushi.
You bitch!
Okay. Can you hear this rumble?
You might want to fly.
We're just going to assume the cremation goes as planned and evacuate the area.
Only you can stop forest fires.
Are you flying to get away from the water she dammed up temporarily?
Yes.
Okay, you realize you're in kind of a ravine, and this, if had you not had the ability to fly, you probably would have been washed away by a river five times the height that it should have been. It actually reaches the top of the bridge, and I'll give you a d20 roll to see if the bridge survives her...
10.
Well, okay, so the bridge is damaged from this. It washes away a couple of dwarves that were on the bridge.
Use a mythic point!
They started running, but, you know, the water just overtook them.
So help them.
I'll help anyone I can.
The pyre and the body is gone. Did you have the wherewithal to take the head?
Oh, yeah, he had the head.
Okay, you had the head. All right.
He wasn't just, I'm going to burn the body and have this here staring at me. Give me the creeps for four hours.
Yeah, you're flying up. You can see the little, this golden pulses a couple times towards the lake up the river. Like it travels in too fast.
Yeah.
Given that you dimension door, it's almost like a visual effect of maybe her golden dimension door underwater. Maybe that's what's going on.
You're okay. Not
sure.
All right. He will quickly return to Dvergholme after he's sure everything's okay. And...
Gel Chris.
All right. So that was using a hero point and gaining the attention of.
So my lady be loyal.
Other mythic beings.
To her, yeah.
Yes, come to us, mythic beings, more power for the slaughter.
I'm a little concerned that my boy might need discipline, or my girl, I don't know what's coming.
Oh, my boy might need discipline.
I need some discipline.
So you clearing the road, and
you ever see the episode of The Simpsons where you find out what they did to Flanders when he was a kid? They're just picking him nonstop for like the entire year. Just do that.
Okay, John. Veil of positive energy. I think I've looked at this one before. I think that's okay. What level of spell is it?
First level, I believe. Let me look.
Bill Craft.
Yeah, it's a first level. It's for paladins.
On this side. It's
okay, so spellcraft. That's something I know something about. Kind of.
So the DC is 12. You could roll knowledge, religion, or spellcraft.
I will do spellcraft, actually. I got a 10, so I guess I'll add mythic. Yay!
Okay, so Veil of Positive Energy was researched. What is the cost of that?
I think it's 100.
100 gold pieces?
Yep.
And basically, you are doing research at the Temple of Morden.
Okay, makes sense.
They trust you enough that you're a paladin and they're able to give you access to
some... You're right. Look, I got this dwarf ring now I'm wearing and I'm growing out my beard, so...
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, we might as well keep this going. What's the next one that you're trying to research?
Light lance.
Light lance? So it's not a heavy lance?
Right? That was a thing. Back in the day.
Glorious beam of radiance. That's a +1 holy lance. +1 round per level. Oh, this is the one you can do the Batman symbol with, where you just kind of keep on...
Yeah,
that's pretty new line of Silverhand. Sure, it's a second level one, so this one is DC 14 to research.
Yeah. I got 15, so I got... It's a 400 gold, I believe, to research second level spells.
Yep.
Okay, I'll mark that off my sheet. So I got that one. Bless you.
What is Heroes Defiance? This is where I don't think I've caught up. So
Heroes Defiance is a first level paladin spell. What it does is when you reduce to zero or fewer hit points, you can expend a use of Lay on Hands ability to heal yourself as if you use Lay on Hands plus an additional 1d6 hit points. If it brings you back up above zero, you may continue to act.
And you can delay the onset of bad conditions. No, that's a feat. Never mind.
That's a feat, yeah. No, Heroes Defiance is basically a verbal component, immediate action, personal spell, paladin one, conjuration healing. If you go down below zero hit points, you can then spend an immediate action to basically lay on hands yourself, plus another d6 healing. And if it brings you back up above zero, you can continue to act normally.
Doctor, heal thyself. Cool spell.
Yeah, essentially.
All right, so DC 12 on this one.
Okay. I got 20, so I got that one. I'll mark the gold off.
Okay.
All right.
Look at you guys using the downtime rules to effectiveness. And then lesser.
I'm really liking these downtime rules, actually.
Lesser angelic aspect. Wow. Okay. I remember this one from a past campaign. This one kind of gets.
Yeah, Ahmed was using it. So with this one, you get low light vision, resistance to acid and cold 5, and the benefits of protection from evil for a minute per level.
Okay. Done.
All right, I'm go ahead.
14, yep.
I'm go ahead and roll that. At 12, I'll add mythic. 5, that's good.
Yeah,
I'll mark off gold pieces. Okay.
And then Litany of... Oh, you just went to 10 on the research, didn't you? It was a good time.
Yeah. I figured we had a lot of time to do this, and I should get as much as I can done.
Yeah, the 8th level, this is kind of like... I don't expect there to be a lot of downtime in the next little while, so this is a Litany of Retribution?
Right. Yeah, this is one of those Lindy spells, which are the cool paladin wizard ones.